All right, let's cut straight to it. Imagine waking up one morning, grabbing your phone, and instead of the usual social media chaos, there's a breaking news headline. Time travel is real. Scientists have cracked it. Suddenly, your brain explodes with possibilities. Could you go back and ace that test you bombed? Prevent embarrassing moments? Invest in Bitcoin when it was worth a fraction of a cent? Maybe meet a dinosaur? But before you start packing for your trip to ancient Egypt, let's pause and ask, how would this actually work? What would happen if time travel wasn't just science fiction, but reality? Buckle up, because things are about to get weird. How would we even time travel? First, let's deal with the elephant in the room. How do we even do it? Right now, time travel is mostly the playground of sci-fi writers and Marvel movies. But physics, specifically Einstein's theory of relativity, actually gives us a few ways it might be possible. For example, did you know that you're already time traveling right now? Yep. Every second, you're moving forward through time, just at the boring old speed of 1 second per second. But according to Einstein, if you moved close to the speed of light, time would slow down for you relative to everyone else. This means that if you hopped on a spaceship, blasted off at nearly light speed, and came back years later, you'd barely have aged while the rest of the world would have moved on. Boom! Time travel to the future. No DeLorean required. But what about traveling to the past? That's where things get complicated. One idea? Wormholes. These hypothetical shortcuts through space-time could, in theory, connect two points, one in the present, one in the past. Step through one end, and congratulations, you're officially a time traveler. Of course, there's a small problem. Wormholes might not actually exist. And if they do, they'd be horrifically unstable, collapsing before you could even step inside. So unless someone invents a TARDIS, we're kind of stuck. But hey, let's say we somehow figure it out. Let's say, tomorrow, scientists build a machine that can actually send you back in time. What happens next? The past would become a complete mess. If time travel was real, history would become absolute chaos. Think about it, every event, every moment, every decision could be changed. Someone could go back and stop major wars, save famous people, or let's be real, mess everything up just for fun. And this is where we run into the biggest headache in time travel, paradoxes. For example, let's say you go back in time and stop your grandparents from meeting. That means your parents were never born, which means you were never born, which means who exactly went back in time to stop them from meeting? This is called the grandfather paradox, and it's one of the biggest reasons scientists think time travel to the past isn't possible. Because if it was, reality itself might just break. Unless, multiple timelines? One way to fix the paradox problem? Parallel universes. Some scientists believe that if you change the past, you don't actually rewrite history, you just create a new timeline. So, if you went back and stopped the dinosaurs from going extinct, you wouldn't change our history, you'd just create a brand new reality where dinosaurs are still stomping around. Meanwhile, in your original timeline, everything stays the same. This is basically how Marvel handles time travel. It's also how quantum mechanics might actually work, where every possible outcome happens in some universe. So, instead of one reality, there could be infinite parallel versions of the world, each with slightly different outcomes. You missed your bus this morning? In another timeline, you caught it. You burned your toast? Somewhere out there, you made the perfect breakfast. You tried to time travel and erased yourself from existence? Well, in some other universe, you didn't. Cool, right? But even if we solve the paradox problem, time travel still wouldn't be safe. It would be a total disaster for humanity. Look, let's be real, if time travel existed, people would absolutely abuse it. Governments? They'd use it to rewrite history in their favor. Billionaires? Insider trading taken to a whole new level. Regular people? Some guy would 100% go back in time just to steal Tesla's ideas before he could patent them. Even small changes could have massive consequences. You ever heard of the butterfly effect? The idea that tiny actions, like stepping on a butterfly in the past, could lead to huge, unpredictable changes in the future. Now imagine if someone went back and made an actual big change, like stopping World War II before it even started. Would that be good? Maybe. But would we still end up with the world we know today? Probably not. Maybe it leads to a worse war. Maybe technology develops differently. Maybe we never even invent YouTube. And that's a world I don't want to live in. So, should we just give up on time travel altogether? Not necessarily. Traveling to the future is theoretically possible, and if we ever figure out faster than light travel, we could basically make time machines for astronauts. As for going back to the past? Well, unless we crack the mystery of wormholes or discover some hidden loophole in physics, it looks like history is staying exactly as it is, which honestly might be for the best. Because let's face it, humans are barely responsible enough to handle social media. Do we really trust ourselves with time travel? Yeah, probably not. But hey, if someone in the future ever figures it out, maybe we'll wake up tomorrow and find a time traveler knocking at our door. And if that happens, ask them for lottery numbers. If you enjoyed this wild thought experiment, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss the next deep dive into absurd science. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.